Craig here from North 49, and at times you find treating BPPV a challenge, especially when the lateral canal is involved and you're not sure what ear it is. Well, if that's the case, this video is for you. In this video, I'll review a technique that I use, being the bow and ling test, to help differentiate what ear it is when I'm not sure when someone has BPPV affecting the lateral canal. With BPPV affecting the lateral canal, my assessment technique of choice is the roll test, where I have the person supine, head elevated slightly, have them roll to the right, have them roll to the left, look for nystagmus, see which way the nystagmus is, and helps me determine which ear is involved. Now, sometimes when you roll them to the right, it's just as provocative as when I roll them to the left, and I'm not sure what ear it is. So in that case, I'll do the bow and lean test. Right? But before we show you what the bow and lean test is, we should review a little bit of anatomy. So I have an anatomical model here. It's the right model of the right ear. This is the lateral, anterior, and posterior canal. This is the front of the head. This is the back of the head. So in particular, with the, with the lateral canal, this is the front of the head again, the back of the head. This is where the cupula is, so that membrane. We have the lateral canal that opens into the vestibule down here. And this aspect would be the anterior arm, and this aspect would be the posterior arm. And we'll talk about that in a bit. And anatomically, the canal is actually perched up 25 to 30 degrees. Remember, this is the front, this is the back, okay? Now, with the bow and lean test, what we have them do, the instructions that we have them, first of all, I have them sitting in a chair, usually have a backrest. I have them sit and lean forward. And I try to get them, actually I put the elbows on the knees and tuck their chin in, because we want to bring that head down approximately 115 to 120 degrees. Because remember that the canal is up like this, we need to get a complete vertical to get those crystals moving, or at least the otoconium moving in there, or the cupula moving, all right? So, or to deflect. So, we have the person, elbows on their knees, have them tuck their chin up all the way, that'll get you to about 115, 20 degrees. Hold it. Hold it for at least 30 seconds. See if it elicits the nystagmus, and if it does, which way does it beat? Now, if it's unsustained nystagmus, it usually beats toward the direction of the affected ear, okay? And if it's sustained nystagmus, it usually beats away from the affected ear, right? Then having them look up is the, after 30 seconds, we know which way it's going. And actually, once they, if you listen to nystagmus, wait and see if it's sustained or unsustained. Once it's gone, have them look up all the way. And you'll need to actually have them look up about 60 degrees. Remember, it's 25 to 30 degrees anyway, so you'll need to go another approximately 60 to 65 degrees to get that lateral canal vertical again. That way it moves the loose otoconia or deflects the cupula if it's got some weight on it because the otoconia are stuck to it. So you have them look up and again, hold it for at least 30 seconds and see if that elicits any nystagmus. And if it does, which way does it beat? If it's sustained nystagmus, the direction it beats, usually indicative of the affected ear. It beats toward the affected ear. And if it's unsustained, it usually beats away from the affected ear. So there you go. The bow and lean test kind of help differentiate which ear it is so you know which ear to treat. So I won't do the bow and lean test off the hop with every patient. I'll do the roll test because that's enough, but sometimes it's equal side to side, so then I'll resort to the bow and lean test. I'll also use the bow and lean test sooner than later when a person's history is really indicative of BPPV, and when I do my range of motion screen, they get dizzy when they look up. I'll put the infrared goggles on and have them look up and see if there's any nystagmus. If there is, I'll note which direction, is it sustained, unsustained, then I'll have them look down, do the bow test, and that do that as well. So kind of the times I would use it right off the hop. If range of motion, looking up, they complain of dizziness, or when I'm not sure after the roll test. So with that in mind, we have an idea of what the test is. Let's see it on a patient. So here we have a patient here sitting in my office, having her looking down, have the goggles on. It really helps with the goggles on so I can see when they're looking down or up. Sometimes it's hard to see. She got dizzy, she kind of sat up. You can see the eyes beating to the left. So there's left beat nystagmus. Have to convince her to kind of sustain that position to see how long the nystagmus lasts. So she's gaining some courage to do so. All right, now she's all in. Let's see what happens. Tucking her chin in, good. Her head's pretty vertical. You can see left beat. Now she's kind of coming out of it. But sometimes you don't even need to get that complete vertical. Gravity's gravity. If it's off the side, it's still going to pull someone's crystals down and elicit nystagmus. You can see it was left beat and it was unsustained. So I'm thinking that she has BPPV effect in the lateral canal because it beats in the plane of the canal and it beat to her left when she looked down. And it was unsustained, so I'm thinking it's her left ear that is involved. So I would treat that ear. But let's do a check. Let's see what happens when she looks up. So she's looking up. And which way is her nystagmus and which direction? It is right beat nystagmus. And it's, is it sustained or unsustained? Let's see. If looking down was unsustained, it should be unsustained looking up, but just getting that pattern, direction, sustained, unsustained, so right beat, and it's starting to slow down. Unsustained, right beat nystagmus with looking up. And in the notes, I'll put just maybe a grid or something that reviews looking up, if it's sustained, unsustained, which direct, you know, which ear's affected, looking down, if it's sustained, unsustained, which ear's affected, just to make it easy for you as well. So there you go, that is the bow and lean test, a useful technique when you're not quite sure which ear's affected when BPPV affects the lateral canal. It's helped me quite a few times. I hope this technique helps you as well. And if you like this video, feel free to like and subscribe. Also check out our website at courses.north49therapy.com for further vestibular educational resources. Thanks and take care.